Hello everyone, welcome back to AutoTrend TV. I'm UV Prajesh again from Tafe Access Limited Tata Car Showroom in Coimbatore today, and I'm here with the new updated XZ Plus variant of the BS6 facelifted Tata Tiago. Well, the updates are on the inside and there is nothing on the outside. As you can see, this is the typical XZ Plus variant. Typical to an XZ Plus variant, this car gets front fog lamps, 15-inch alloy wheels and contrast black finish on the ORVMs. The XZ Plus variant also can have an optional contrast black roof color. Moving towards the rear, of course, you get to see a rear windshield wiper washer defogger along with a reverse parking camera mounted just below the Tiago badging. So there is no change on the outside of this XZ Plus variant. You may have seen my quick update video on the XT variant. So I am expecting similar kind of changes on the interior of this XZ Plus variant as well. So let's get inside now. Yes folks, I am right now inside the new updated XZ Plus variant of the Tata Tiago BS6 facelift. And well, let me just quickly show you the dashboard. This is the exact same dashboard as on any other XZ Plus variant. You get the digital instrument cluster, flat bottom steering wheel with steering motor audio controls. You also get front fog lamps and rear windshield wiper washer as well. And of course, you also get auto folding ORVMs on this top spec variant. You also get this 7-inch touchscreen system from Connect Next, and it is paired to 8 speakers from Harman. So no change whatsoever, and even the automatic climate control console remains the same, along with the gear lever, which is a 5-speed manual transmission, the handbrake lever, the center console. Everything remains exactly the same, and of course the driver seat also gets height adjustment on the top spec XZ and XZ Plus variants. So coming to the changes, of course, here we go. Well, just have a look at this new door pad design and the armrest design of the new updated Tiago range. Well, you may have seen that on the XT, XE and the XZ variants, the same armrest was there. However, those door handles were fully in black plastic, whereas on this top spec variant exclusively you get metal finish. This is proper metal feeling door handles. These are not plastic as far as I can see, and the fit and finish and the overall quality seems really very well. As I predicted, they have given metal finish only for this top spec XZ Plus variant. No other variant gets this metal finish, and overall, as you can see, the door pad itself feels quite mature and more sophisticated in terms of design when you compare with the old one. Here's a quick look at the passenger side door as well. As you can see, all the doors get the same metal finish chrome door handle, which looks really very good and befitting the top spec variant. And however, you can see that the armrests, even on this top spec variant, do not get any sort of fabric or cushion padding and remain exactly plastic, just like on the lower spec variants. So this is all about the update on the interior. Well, just for formality, I'll just try starting the car. Well, this here is the flip key. No change to the flip key, of course. Only one flip key is provided for the top spec variants. The spare key is a regular non-flip key one. And this is how the dashboard looks like when everything is turned on. The digital instrument cluster, of course, you are familiar with it. The Connect Next infotainment system also is very easy to use. It has got Android Auto, Apple CarPlay and 8 speakers with Bluetooth connectivity. And you also got automatic climate control, which is displayed over here. Let me just try turning on. As you can see, you can control the climate control using the touchscreen system itself. So that is also really very good. And if you pair Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, you can also use voice commands, for which the button is located on the steering wheel. So that was all about that. Coming to the roof, you of course get the day night switch for the IRVM. The interior cabin light is located at the center and is a full LED unit, even on the base XE variant. So that was all about the updates. The main update is only the door handle and the armrest design. So do let me know, what do you think about this new armrest design? And of course, another thing I would like to note, that there is no price increase for this design update. So that's all. Meanwhile, this is Viprajesh signing off. See you on another video. Thank you for watching.